This is me, and this is my mate Marty, and we like cars. Lots of cars. We love buying them, fixing them, modifying them, racing them, and even destroying them. We've driven cars in countries all over the world, but now we're setting our sights on our very own backyard, the Australian Outback. We'll be starting in Sydney on the East Coast and travelling west to one of the most desolate and dangerous places on the planet, Central Australia. And to get there, we're going to try and borrow cars from people we meet along the way. This is Lend Us a Ride, Australia. Our journey starts in Sydney, Australia's biggest city, located on the east coast of the country. And we're going to be travelling thousands of kilometres to the outback in the middle of Australia. And Marty's organised us an awesome car to begin our journey. So Marty, the big adventure, we've done Japan, we've been to all places all around the world.
Yep, dude, and this is going to be epic and I've got us the best car ever.
Yep. When you rang me and said you've organised us a car, I was like, finally you got us a mad Jeep. Something big, because we're going to the desert, man. Dude, we're going to one of the most desolate parts of the planet.
I got us something even better, more efficient, more stylish, more room, like everything you could want from a car you're going to do a road trip with.
This is the dead end of a street, though, and there is nothing here except for that. Do not tell me we are going to the outback in that. We have thousands of kilometres to do. I'm not going in that car,
man. We are going to the outback.
What is wrong with you?
In that. Because it's perfect, man. Look how much space it's got. You can fit everything in the boot. You can fit us in comfort style. Everyone will be looking at us thinking we're absolute legends.
Dude, that is the worst choice for a car to take to the outback. Of all of the crappy cars you've bought, that is the worst option we have. It looks old. I mean, how old is that car?
I think the car is like 32 years old.
Which means it has a 32-year-old engine, which means we're completely screwed. Dude. We're going to break down. We're going to need oil for it. We're going to need spark plugs. It's probably got holes in the exhaust like the last car that we bought.
Dude.
We're completely... Really screwed, man.
Doesn't have.
I'm not taking that to the outback.
It doesn't have an exhaust.
It doesn't. Why doesn't it have an exhaust? Is it a Flintstones car?
It doesn't have a 32-year-old engine. That is electric.
No.
Yes.
Really?
Charging our way up across the country, man. Plugging into stuff and driving around.
That is an electric car.
That's an electric car.
Look at the car.
It's awesome. It's perfect.
This is a 1982 Daihatsu Mira. It was originally fitted with a two-cylinder engine and had a top speed of only 120 k's an hour. The interior is functional and feral. It's got truck suspension in the back and absolutely zero mod cons. This particular Mira has a 144-volt DC electric conversion that uses a forklift motor in place of the old dinosaur-munching petrol engine. This is one of the first homebrew electric car conversions around and made its way onto countless TV and news stories. It costs around 29 cents for a full charge and I absolutely love it, but not everyone's convinced.
It looks amazing, it's safety blue out in the desert amongst that all that, you know, desert. We're gonna stand out and be so safe.
See all the batteries? That's what's gonna get us across the country.
This is frightening.
This is awesome. Look
this
at
is
it,
the
man.
Most frightening road trip
you are
we've
looking,
done.
You are looking at the future right there.
Is this dangerous?
No, that's where the...
Has that got cardboard holding the batteries in?
That's where it caught on fire once, I think. That's what that is.
Is there cardboard holding this car together, dude?
That's crash safety in case so the batteries don't move in the event of a
you
crash.
You are unbelievable. Unbelievable, mate.
Look at all the space, mate. This is so practical.
You can drive because I'm going to keep my door unlocked and the window open so I can dive out when this explodes. Actually, that has to come with us. That has to come with us.
Let's do it, man. You're going to love it.
How do we start it? What does that mean? That looks dangerous.
No, that's
what does town mean? That looks dangerous. Why are there wires hanging out
there?
There's exposed wires near your feet.
It's okay.
There's exposed wires near my feet.
It's only 144 volts, mate. It's completely safe. So,
look at the speedos. What the hell, man? It looks like something out of an old mixing desk from Abbey Road.
That's
being held on with sticky tape.
That's your economy gauge.
Oh, man.
Anyway, we've got our battery isolator, so that's on. And we don't even need to be in neutral because there's no clutch. And ready, and then we turn the key.
No clutch.
No, ready, listen. That is the sound of the future.
Are we on?
We're on. And now, we don't even need the clutch. We pick a gear, and we're ready to go.
You just went into second gear.
I know. Will you drive around in second gear? Listen to that. There's nothing to listen to because it's just total silence.
That's amazing.
I know. And this is us, man. This is us on our trip.
It's actually pretty comfortable.
It's awesome.
It's actually pretty good. It's all our stuff fits in the back. Has it got indicators and stuff? Is it registered?
It's a proper registered, engineered, blue slip, everything.
Wow.
Vehicle.
Is it
legal
quick?
To drive.
We don't have to wait for the engine to warm up, so we can plant it right now. Holy shit, boss! Oh my God!
This is us, man. This is us. There's so many reasons why this car's perfect, man. Like, it is, it's economical, it's easy on the planet, we've got a massive range, we can charge it up when we're in the outback because people have solar stations and they'll lend us a PowerPoint. All those nice people in the country go like, here, have some extension cords.
You actually love it, don't you?
I love it.
You absolutely love it.
I love it.
And we're going to take an electric car all the way to the outback.
Exactly right. Nathan. Hey, man. Do you reckon you could lend us a ride? Yeah, just the electric car didn't go all that well.
Oh! Yes! Yes!
That's right.
Yes!
The DMC-12 DeLorean has a history and a future unlike any other car. Developed from the dream of John DeLorean in the late 1970s, the ex-General Motors executive eventually set up a factory in Northern Ireland, where around 9,000 were produced before the company ran out of money and went under. The car was immortalised in the Back to the Future trilogy. The fictional flux capacitor was developed by Doc Brown and made it possible for the car to travel through time when you hit 88 miles an hour. This particular example is far from original. Under the rear hatch lives a 6-litre V8 engine from a Commodore, a manual gearbox, and enough electronic gadgets to run a space station, which is handy when you're travelling through time and space.
I'm very happy we're out of that electric car, though. Good luck. A tow truck is on the way, so you'll be
thank
laughing.
You, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Marty,
no worries,
let's do this thing. Actually, that's your side. We're meant to be going back in time, not in reverse the whole way.
This has the worst turning circle of any car ever in the history of time and space.
How good's the headroom though, Martin?
Oh, the gear shift's on the right hand side, I'm freaking out. All right, here we go.
Which way is, wait on, is it, oh.
That's first.
Oh, okay.
Any cars around?
I can't see, Martin. I can't
neither
see anything.
Neither can I.
Wait, no, oh yeah, try, go a bit more. Yeah, we're all good.
We're all.
Oh! We're on our way to the outback, Martin.
Yes, we are.
Oh! Alright.
Dude, V8 DeLorean.
I know.
With a flux capacitor and everything.
It was a beautiful sunny day as we left Sydney. Not really. With 300 kilowatts, a V8 DeLorean sounds like a great idea, unless it's raining, and then it's absolutely terrifying. As we got further out of the city, the weather got worse and worse.
We basically keep going along this way until we get to M4,
yep.
Great Western Highway,
yep.
And then wind up through the mountains that way. Hey Benny, how you going? Yeah, all right mate, we just left this morning. We got stuck on the M7 for a while and now that the weather is properly epic, just gray clouds and rain. Yeah, oh, the DeLorean's a V8, so it's a bit sketchy. We're actually wondering if you can lend us a ride. We've got the DeLorean all the way to the mountains where we're stopping off at a place called Govett's Leap and hoping maybe you can lend us a Subaru or something because the just the road is slippery, the weather is epic, and I think it's like, we've agreed it's proper Subaru weather, so do you reckon you could bring us something? That's fine, yeah, Liberty, Forester, Rexy, whatever you got at the shop, that's fine.
Awesome. Thanks a lot, man. Cool, man. Okay. Yeah, we're on our way there now. Okay, bye.
We're heading towards Govett's Leap to pick up our all-weather, all-wheel drive road-tripping machine. We've arrived in the Blue Mountains, around 100 kilometres west of Sydney. The mountains form part of the Great Dividing Range, which stretches 3,500 kilometres down the east coast of Australia. The Blue Mountains quite literally appear blue, and here you'll find loads of small villages, tourists, and the greatest variety of eucalyptus trees on the continent. Wow, Govett's Leap, check it out, man.
We're actually up in the clouds.
I'm sure there's probably normally an epic view from here, but there is literally nothing but white for as far as the eyeballs can see. We got about 20 minutes to wait until Ben's here. He's bringing us a mad Subaru.
Yeah, perfect for this weather, like all drive and practical, lots of grip.
Pretty good. What is that? What is that?
That's not a Subaru, mate. That is not a Subaru.
Is that Benny? Benny! That's not a Subaru!
This is a 1950 Buick Super Riviera sedan. It's classic American metal at its finest. This one has an inline eight known as the Fireball and a two-speed automatic gearbox. You heard right, two speeds. When this car was built, the world was entering the jet age. If you were wealthy enough, you might find yourself on one of the first commercial jetliners, and you might drive yourself to the airport in your Buick. The inside is a lounge room with a built-in steering wheel. With its bomb sight up front and venti ports along the front guards, meant to look like the exhaust ports of a fighter jet, the Buick was an imposing, fire-breathing, dinosaur-burning monster.
Benny!
Hey, mate.
Hey,
how
Benny.
Are you?
How you going, bro? This is awesome. I thought we were getting some kind of Subaru Forester-y thing.
Surprise, man.
Wow.
Yeah.
What's the deal with this?
Fresh in the country, so I just brought it over and...
What year is it?
1950, man.
1950.
A 1950 Buick.
Yeah.
That is unreal. Where are the seat belts?
What seat belts?
Okay, good. Benny, you are a lifesaver. Awesome.
Enjoy it.
Enjoy the DeLorean.
Oh,
real. Let us know what 1985 is like.
Benny's taking the DeLorean back to Sydney, and we're going to drop the Buick off on the other side of the mountains. The Buick's got trampoline seats, no seat belts, and the speedo is in miles. It really is an experience. We made it halfway down the mountains before our drum brakes failed. But when you're in a Buick, it's impossible not to be calm, cool, and collected. Marty's on the phone to organise our next car as we continue to cruise. It really is one of the most incredible cars I've ever seen.
We've successfully crossed the mountains and made our way to Lithgow, where we're collecting our next car and we're both very excited. This is our mate James, and his car used to be our car. Many years ago, we purchased this from eBay for $500 and it had a blown engine. So we took it out, put a new one in, and turbocharged it. This little car started its life as a Daihatsu Cure, but with the help of fans from our YouTube series, we decided to turn it into a show car, a one-of-a-kind with a handmade body kit, turbo system, interior, and paint job. We worked on this car for almost a year and we're really proud of it because it went from this to this. And then James got it and made it even better. That was years ago and now we can't wait to get behind the wheel again.
James is taking the Buick back to Benny's place, and we're going to take his car to his parents' place in Parkes, which is 350 kilometres west of Sydney. This style of car may not be that popular in Australia, but in Japan, they are everywhere and have a cult following that's starting to spread to other countries around the world.
It's pretty awesome, Marty, to be in this car, considering that we used to actually own this car.
That's right, man. This was the fan-funded show car.
Yeah.
Way back in the day.
This is great. We launched this in 2010
yep.
at our final Battle Auto Salon in Sydney.
Yep.
And we've gone today from an electric car to a V8 DeLorean, to a straight-eight Buick, now to a Daihatsu
exactly.
with a little custom turbocharger on it. And this is awesome.
You know what I love the most about this car as well? It was fan-funded and everyone got like really into it back in the day of like, you know, people donated 20 cents or 50 cents or a dollar or whatever it was. And we had this budget to do the car and then it's still going and it's even better than it was then.
Oh, it's even better than it was. And I think there was something like 460 people from all over the world all donated a couple of cents for us to build this car.
Yep.
And now all these years later, we're in it and we get to take it all the way to park. So we've got a few hundred kilometers. I think the thing is that's a little bit scary is that we've been able to call in some favors from mates in Sydney.
Yep.
Once we get through the mountains and we're in parks, there's gonna be no more favors from people we know. We're gonna be borrowing cars from people that we haven't even met yet. And it's gonna be frightening, but until then, I think we can just sit back and enjoy this mad little car that used to be ours. I love it, man.
It's
so good. And listen to the induction. Listen to it. Sizzle.
The turbo, man. It's awesome.
Give it a little bit, Martin. Give it a little bit of sizzle.
We drove on. Soon it got dark. And the weather got worse. But eventually, we made our way to a motel in Parkes. And tomorrow, we've got to try and get our hands on another car to continue our journey.